What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to create a spiral stair in Revit. And it's not going to be just any spiral stair, it's actually going to be a very special spiral stair, and I'm going to be showing you how to create a spiral stair with a support. Now, supports are really important with spiral stairs. Usually you just have like a column in the middle, and then all of the steps kind of attach to that column, and it's a very small point of connection, so you need to reinforce it. And unfortunately, Revit doesn't really have any tools which we can use to create something like that. There's no like a switch or an option that you turn on and then you get the support. So I've developed this workaround, or this hack, so to speak, in order to get around this and get the support that we need for each of our steps. So that's what I'm going to be showing you in this video. Apart from the spiral stair, we're going to be creating that support. Now, speaking of stairs and railings, if you're interested in pretty much learning everything that there is to know about stairs and railings in Revit, I actually have a course. So it's available on my website, balkanarchitect.com. It's going to be the first link just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. So I'd like to encourage you to check it out. I have that course. Obviously, I have many more different courses on different topics in Revit for different levels of Revit knowledge. But also, apart from that, quite recently I have added some really high quality Revit families which you can actually buy on my website. They just kind of add another level of realism to your models. So if you're interested in checking that out, as I said, just the first link in the description of the video or the card above. Okay, now without any further ado, let's jump into Revit. And as you can see here, we are at our Revit's home screen, and let's just go here to models, go to new, and for the template file I'm just going to be using my Balkan my architecture design template, the metric version, and that's also something that's available on my website. Okay, so this is just the starting view. So I'm just going to go here to elevations and then go to the south elevation, and here let's change the level height down from 360 to 300 centimeters, just because I want a lower stair, so to speak. Now let's move to level 1 and create the actual stair. So for the stair, what you want to do is just go to the architecture tab, you want to go to the circulation panel, then you go to the stair tool, you click, and then you have just a couple of options. So the first option is your full step spiral. So this means that you have a spiral stair that's just one piece. You don't really have any landings in the middle or something like that. So in those cases, I would encourage using this one. Also, we have the center end spiral, which is for situations where you perhaps want to add some sort of a landing in the middle. I just found that this option works better for that. So I'm just going to go with the full step spiral. This is going to be very simple. Come in here, and I've clicked before I should have, so I'm just going to hit the escape key once, and then let's go here to the properties and change this to the assembled stair 190mm max riser, 250mm going. So let's go with that. Again, let's click here. You want to zoom in a little bit so we can kind of have it like this, kind of go all the way around. I like the way that this looks. Okay, so once we have created our spiral stair, we can just hit finish for now, and Revit is just going to generate that stair. And if I go here to the default 3D view, we're just going to see what that looks like. Man, looks good enough for now, but we're actually going to be making some modifications. So the first modification is to the actual stair. So for this stair, we're just going to have just our treads, which connect directly to the column in the middle, which we don't really have at the moment, but we're going to be making that. But first, let's adjust this stair. So what I'm going to do is select the stair, and then what you want to do is go here to the edit type menu. That's going to open up the type properties. Let's just rescale this a little bit so we can see it better. Okay, now here we first want to get rid of the supports. As I said, the column is going to be our support, so we just go here to supports, right support. It's currently set at a stringer, so you just go and set that to none. You do the same thing with the left support, and then you hit apply, and as you can see, now those supports are gone. Next, you want to change the run type as well. So you just go here to the run type. As you can see, it's 50 millimeters for the tread and 13 millimeters for the riser. I don't want the riser. I think it's ugly. So let's click here. So it's just that little builder button that you have here. You click on that and then you can go here to treads and risers. Just uncheck the riser and you're pretty much done. Hit apply. Okay, apply, okay, and now as you can see it looks much cleaner. Obviously it looks like it's kind of floating mid-air, but that's okay. Okay, so for the next step, we have to figure out that support. So I'm going to do the column last, just because it kind of masks out the center part of the stair, so I don't want that currently. So let's talk about the supports. So for the supports, you can obviously model them as a simple family, perhaps a generic family or a face-based family, and then just apply it to the each step, but that would take a long time, and I don't find that to be very effective. So that got me thinking, what would be the most efficient way to do that? And, well, I think the railing is the result, or is the solution. So what I did is I just selected the railing here, and let's switch this to like a regular 110 millimeter railing because it has all of these posts or balusters along the way. Now currently, if you look at this, we have this first kind of baluster kind of off to the side of the first one. We have the same thing going on in the second one, then the third one doesn't really have a baluster, then this one has it, then this one doesn't, and so on. So this doesn't really look good. And also it's here in the middle, which is also kind of giving us some issues just because it's so kind of squeezed together. You don't want that. So what I did is I went here to the offset from path. So the path is kind of that inner circle here, so just the inner circle of the stair. So that's kind of the path on which that railing is hosted. So what you want to do is select that railing, go to the offset path, and let's add a 50 centimeter offset. So it's just going to place it here like this, in on kind of on top of the on top of each thread in the middle of the stair. Now again, we have a problem where somewhere, as you can see here, we have like three of these balusters, then we have two on each, and that's also something that's going to be really difficult to work with. Here again, we have three, so it's really annoying. So let's fix that. So I'm just going to select this railing, go here into edit type, and then here inside of edit type, you have the baluster placement option. You can click on that, and then here for the baluster placement, you have this use baluster per tread on stairs. So if you have a stair, how many balusters will be hosted on each step? That kind of makes sense. Now you can uncheck that if you don't want to use that on the stairs or anything, but obviously I do. So let's change this to one. So that would be just one baluster on each step, hit apply, okay, apply, okay, and now we have a change. Now as you can see, now we have like one baluster in the middle of each of the steps. Now here we have two, in the beginning we have two, and in the end we have two. Now this is a different issue. Now this is an issue, if I just go here into edit type for this railing, this is an issue again with baluster placement, but because we have these posts. So it just includes posts which are kind of in the beginning, in the middle, or in the end, or at the bends or corners, and we don't really want them for this kind of situation. So I'm just going to go here for the space and just zero all of these out. That's my first step. And having done that, I'm just going to also get rid of these. So just go to none for all of these. Apply. Okay, apply. Okay. And now here we have something that's starting to look really good. Now each of our treads has one baluster on that, and it's also centered, which is also really good. Now what I'm going to do, and you're probably already guessing this, I'm actually going to hack the baluster family to include a support that's going to be below the stair. So by doing that, I'm just going to be transforming my railing into the supports for the stair, which is quite cool. So what do we do now? Well, now we have to create our own customized baluster family. So to do something like that, what you want to do is go here to the file menu, go to new family. There we go, new family. And then here for the family, that's just a regular baluster. So just go to metric baluster, hit open, and yeah, this is what we get. Now, currently, if you can see here from the view, it's called left. So we're looking at this baluster kind of from the left. Now, if I go back here to the 3D view, for example, if we're concentrating on this baluster here, currently we're looking at it from the left. But I want to look at it from the front and then model that support here below the step. So that's what we want to do. So let's go here to the baluster, baluster family. And I'm just going to use actually none of this. Go to the front elevation, zoom in a little bit. And then here, let's go to extrusion. We want to pick a work plane, which is just going to be the center left right. Click OK. Oops, I wanted to say left, front, back. Okay, name. Front back, okay, this will work, there we go. And now here we have to kind of worry about a couple of things. So the first one is the offset. So obviously we want to go below each of the treads, so that's 50 millimeters because all of the treads are 50 millimeters, so you want to add 50 millimeters there, so we want to have that. Now also, this is the center of the stair. Now the stair goes another 500 millimeters off to this side. Is that 500? Oops, I don't want you. Delete, okay. So 500, there we go. So it's going 500 here, this is the center, and let's actually extend it. Let's go to 520, just so it goes a little bit into the column. So 520, and then let's see how wide is it? I don't know, let's go with 160. And then it goes up and then it stops at some point. So it can stop perhaps here, just like that. Maybe we can move it up a little bit. There we go, something like this. It can actually be 140, I don't think we have to overdo it like this. Perhaps like that, perfect. Now you can just get rid of this. And then you can go to trim and extend to corner, fix it up here, here, and here. There we go. And then finally for the extrusion end and extrusion start, the extrusion end can be, you just look at the thickness. So let's say I want this to be, I don't know, like 4 centimeters thick. So I would say 20 millimeters here, minus 20 here. So it starts from minus 20, goes up to 20, making it 40 in total. And now when I look at that from the left, it just looks like this. So that's what this is going to look like when we load it into the project. Now you want to save this family, so you just go to save. Let's save it on desktop. Let's call it the stair support. Okay, we have saved that. Now you want to load that into the project. Now you have the option to load and close. I don't use that in a situation such as this one, just because you don't know, you might want to kind of play around with the family a little bit if something didn't work out. Anyways, let's go back here, let's go back to the family, select this, go into edit type, the railing family. You want to go here to, well, actually let's go to the top rail, or no, let's go to baluster placement first. Okay, so here for this I want to go with none, and then for the baluster family here I want to use my stair support. And also here, I want it to be kind of from host base offset should be minus, that was 140 plus 50, that's 190 or 19 centimeters. So you just want to play around with these so you don't mess anything up. But I think if we have now set this correctly, and I think we did, hit apply and then OK. And then also I want to get rid of the top rail and then hit apply, click OK. This is what happens. Now, isn't that beautiful? So now we have just that railing is acting in as the support of each of the steps. And this is really beautiful, if you ask me. So there you go. That's how you do this. And then finally, you just add like a column in the middle, which is super simple. So you just go to architecture column, architectural column. Do we have a round one? Nope. Let's go to load family, columns. There we go. Round column. Okay, open that up. Go into level 1. This is too small. Do we have a bigger one? This is way too large. Okay, let's go with this one. And then obviously we don't really have anything to attach it to, which is quite annoying. So let's do this. Let's first measure out. So we go from here to here. So it's 20 millimeters in total. And then also I like to just go here to annotate. And then what I do is just take detail lines and create like a detail line that follows this. And then or like a detail line that follows this and then the center. There we go. And then you just go to modify, you go to trim and extend. And now you have like the center of that. Then you go back to architecture, back to column, architecture column, and then you go into edit, duplicate, and let's create just a new column for this. So 200 millimeter diameter, and we set the diameter to 20. Click OK, and now we just, is it not going to allow me to snap to this? Okay, that's super annoying. Can we use model lines? Let's hope this works. Seriously? Okay, there's something wrong with this column. But anyways, it worked out. It's there. It's in the center. We solved it, guys. There we go. Doesn't that look awesome? I really like these, and the solution of using this by railing. And the thing is, you can just save this family and now you can use it on whichever project you want to use it on. It's not like you have to redo this whole process again. It's just done. It's completed. So that's why I really like this. So there you go. That's how you create a kind of a spiral stair around the column with the support in a very cool way. So I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to get this family without the hassle of having to do it yourself, you can find this project file and this family, as well as the rest of my project files and families, on my Patreon page, which is going to be the second link just below this video in the description, and it will also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.